proper story is supposed to start at the beginning. Ain't so simple with this one. Now here's a kid whose whole world got all twisted, leaving him stranded on a rock in the sky. He gets up, sets off for the Bastion, where everyone agreed to go in case of trouble. Ground forms up under his feet as it points the way. He don't stop to wonder why. Finds his lifelong friend just lying in the road. Well, it's a touching reunion. He sees what's left of the rippling walls, years of work undone in an instant, in the calamity. That a survivor? No, ma'am. It's a gas fella, forced out from underground. Kid pops him good. Fella got a piece of him, though. An old repeater falls out of the sky. Ain't a gift from the gods, but it'll have to do. Got a holder still to spin up the chamber. Kid's worked up quite a thirst by now, so that fountain looks real inviting. Sometimes you just need a drink. A school of squirts tunneled up around him. Must have fled here from the mines. Kid finds a memento from a girl he knew. Always used to fancy her. It's a wonder the old saloon's still standing. Used to have the nicest view. He sets foot inside one of Celandia's famous watering holes. Inside's old Rondi, the bartender. The calamity got him before his drinking did. Kid finds his trusty shield. But just as he's getting a handle on it, the security takes him for a petty thief. Special delivery. Gas fellas. Windbags start turning up for last call. Squirts start coming out of the woodwork. A big old fella pops out in front of the kid. Kid sees the way to the Bastion out the window. It's a bit of a drop. He gets a good look at things on his way down. He lands on top of a breaker's bow, and it ain't broke. Kid spies a good perch for some target practice. He knows he should draw the string all the way back. Wasn't long before the kid could loose an arrow, strong and true. The kid pockets a memento from a breaker, once the fastest man in the land. Good news is the emergency defenses still work. Bad news is they aim at the kid. Arsenal. Tough part of town. One sip of the spirits in that distillery, and the kid'll feel like a new man. Arsenals where the kid can pick the best tools for the job. Some of them squirts birthing like crazy in a couple of corners. Sends the kid on his way. The bastion's real close now. Takes a chunk of alloy, smell of barley and spoiled blueberries fills the air. Scumbags. Kid maybe shouldn't have done what he just did.
gets him out of his misery. He finds the core to the wharf district. He steals the city's heart. Might as well. Kid has a feeling you better get a move on. The place is starting to fall. See, that core Kid took was the only thing making this particular rock stay afloat. Kid just keeps running. To go. Now the kid sees something stranger still. His mind races. Did anybody else survive? Sure enough, he finds another. He finds me. We talk for a spell. There's a bit of the Bastion's power in that crest, enough to point the way to the cores. All I tell him is to set that core of his on the monument there, then watch. I try to let the kid down gently. This is the Bastion, all right, except no one else showed up. Just like that, the Bastion comes alive. Starts growing again. Growing stronger. Kid's gotta put its power to good use. Now the Bastion can send him even farther into the wild unknown. Kid ponders what to build. The Bastion's a place of peace, but we can hold our own if we have to. A repeater goes with a hammer better than a box of nails. Kid don't know what's out there waiting for him. The Skyway. Now the kid can ride the wind to distant lands. workmen ward. Them windbags used to keep the city humming along here. The Breaker Barracks. Many straight shooters learn their way here. Now he lands at the intersection between bad and wrong. Ought to be a core down one of these twisted streets. But which one? He heads for the squirt steps. Won't be no field trip this time. Scumbag can digest just about anything. Except for this. It's quick for slicing. And light enough to throw. Say even the most rambunctious squirts can be tamed. No sign of the core here. At least the kid got something for his trouble. Them squirts just don't know when to quit. He heads for the east side, where windbags used to keep the local forge. Inside the forge, Key can fine-tune those instruments of his. Kid's lifelong friends looking fit to keep on fighting. So he's gotta guess again. Odd place to find the likes of Percy the Snitch. Up north is where the gas fella foreman used to live, tending to his flock. Gas fellas all dress alike. Kids wondering the same thing. And there it is, but it's locked down tight in an alloy cage. A blustery old foreman's keeping his fellas in check, almost like he's showboating for the crowd. it's grown, but it's too tough to fall. Might as well check the other side streets before leaving this hole. Comes back, just like I knew he would. The core hums in his pack. The monument's calling for it. The windbags used to be all right. Then the calamity took the floor out from under him. Kid does it again. Only fair he decides what we build next. A lot of things need fixing up in this world, and we can start right here. Sometimes a single look says it all. Picked up traces of other cores while the kid was out. The melting pot. Place hoarded all sorts of fineries from beyond the boundless sea. The sundown path. Lovely place for a stroll, before the calamity, that is. The breakers used to come here for target practice. Used to play a little game. See who could bust the most targets in the fewest shots. Focused, he's armed, and he's off. A perfect shot just happens in a flash. He returns with some of the materials we need. In better days, the melting pot was sealed tighter than the skin on a squirt. Of all the plans to survive the calamity, it had to be stab weeds. Blasted things hurt like a broken heart. If there's a core, he figures it ought to be deeper down. Core stuck inside one of those fancy cages. Some of the stuff lying around is downright dangerous. It throws a switch. Now what could possibly go wrong? Quite a bit, as it turns out. The cage starts lifting from the core ever so slow. All Kid can do is wait. Shipments start falling in. Not every squirt's born bad. Some spring to the Kid's defense. Judging by the movement of the cage, it's gonna take a little while. Scumbags don't take kindly to interlopers. At this rate, maybe 5 more minutes. Maybe 30. Hard to tell. Squirts get real territorial around the core. Then a ship in a free sample shows up. Left. Core goes free. 10, 9, 8, 7. Give or take a few seconds. Finally, the core's within reach. And done. He's got it. Just gotta get to the nearest barge. I still remember the look on his face after that one. but the new world's just getting started. Folks voyaged across the boundless sea to found Zelandia. It was good living here for a while. Makes time to sample spirits from my personal supply. Cinder brick style sure goes down smooth, then stays in your gut like a rock. Can't be too careful these days. That's Windbag Ranch. Perfect place to work a blade if you got the stomach for it. Couples used to walk the sundown path. Kid ain't here for pleasure, though. But then, somebody gets to the core before the kid. The floor starts giving way under the lightest step. A single panic squirt would bring the whole place down. Fragments of the old world rain in the sky. Well, the path ain't exactly open to visitors no more. Security's all fired up. See, the path was intended for leisurely strolling and such. Sky bridges link the path together. One of them bridges whips the kid along. Air travel always was an iffy proposition. The calamity changed everything, even where the wind blows. Well, if we mastered the winds in the old days, we could do it again. But the question is, who else could have taken the core? Well, ain't no survivor stole the thing. Ship live munitions down the path. Find time to find him. He's wise to toss those things plenty far away. Even gas fellas need some shut eye from time to time. They get real cranky. Wait. it keeps coming back to an overwhelming question. Who else could have survived the calamity? So he didn't find the core that time, but that ain't about to stop us. That's Trapper Shingle, only place in the city to go to get certified with a repeater. The dead welcome him with open arms. The calamity took everybody after all. Kids sees it plain, frozen faces all around. These folks never saw the calamity coming, but someone did. Someone close. Sees him there again, in the flesh. It's a snag or two trying to get to him. He ain't about to stop, no matter what. He's got so many questions after all. Never saw what it was like beyond the walls. Nor did the bird boy. Didn't make it. The Jawsons, they didn't make it. Grady Sr., Grady Jr., they didn't make it. But him, he survived. Just think, without that man, we wouldn't be here right now, would we? The core survived as well. Kid does what he has to do, and then... What do you say to a man who's seen too much? Kid hasn't a clue, but he says this. We have to go, please. He's a proper gentleman, that man. His name is Zulf. No hiding, he's an Ura. Folks like him ain't never been a common sight in Zelandia. He's relieved to see a living face or two. The kid and I introduce ourselves in kind. Both to him and to each other for the first time. For Zulf, Zelandia was like a second home. He's real worried about his first home, too. Far to the east. We all lost loved ones in the calamity, he says. I don't know how I'm gonna go on without mine. What else is there to say? F- fetching fizz is like a mouthful of nails, but the benefits are worth it. Kid ain't finished here yet. The cores, they remember. That's why this place is coming together. That's why things are gonna be all right. Well, look what we have here. The lost and found. Here, Kid takes fragments of the old world and makes them whole again. All it takes is some fragments, and the Bastion makes it good as new. Turns out those old bones still have some spark in them. That ought to make those fangs sink in nice and deep. We tracked down a couple more cores near the edge of the city. That cinder brick fort, where the marshals used to watch over the city. There's only one way in the cinder brick fort. Sure, the city marshals may be gone, but now the fort's crawling with windbags. The calamity was mercy. So lucky. They've been left to freeze or starve or face the kid. What windbags, young and old, fighting for the fort. At least the marshals left the kid a parting gift. Something the windbags just can't handle. Something that'll punch clean through their greasy eyes. Windbags ain't much different from normal folks. All they want's a warm place to stay and a decent meal. The calamity drove the windbags topside. Very fort. Could have been minding the business underground like in the old days. kid sure can. He stashes the marshal's prize. Goes back to something more his style. Cinderbrick gave him enough heat and metal to munch on for a while. Well, the fort ain't theirs by right. Can't blame them for wanting it, though. So many of those sorry things holed up inside that old fort. Not a scratch on him as he presses on the higher ground. Stash of grenades is there for him if things get even worse. Secured his plane gone haywire. Windbags gummed up the works. They trapped the kid in the middle of the fort's parade grounds. Sorry, hides to lose. Kid takes that Glutus. Or maybe it was Glandon. Kid used to dream of getting Marshall's badge, but not like this. And now ain't nothing left for nobody down at Cinderbrick Fort. Kid shows up just as Ulf's telling me about his own journey to the city. The marshal seemed like a good man, he says. They treated him with dignity. Zolf's travels ain't much compared to what the kids had to go through for all this. Zolf brought his antique smoking pipe all the way from the terminals. Kid says hello, but Zolf's lost in thought. Seems the only thing the Calamity saved for Zolf was his smoking pipe. since the Ura surrendered to us, the Marshals kept a wary eye on him. The Bastion ain't gonna build itself. Well, not entirely. Be a kid can pay respect to the old world and earn it in kind. The valediction. Just another one of my sketches. Nothing more. Words can't express what happened, but they're all I got. That's the scrapyard, where folks got to smash things and call it community service. That's the bullhead court. Folks defended themselves there with shields, not words. There's Pith Orchard, built in honor of the bull, and folks like Zulf, who pray to him. No use praying to the gods these days. No time for it either. Kid says a little prayer anyway. Couldn't hurt, right? Folks used to make pilgrimage here to pay their respects to Pith, the bull. Well, the gods are long gone now, and the Orchard Core is long gone too. The gods don't care about trinkets, but the kid ain't no god. It stood for something once. Something real. In time, though, the bull stopped being a symbol and started being decoration. Pith makes a decent scarecrow, at least. Then Pith lights up like a rodeo. Ain't easy punching through his hide. Kid breaks him to bits. Must have been guarding that shrine. So what'll it be? Invoke the gods, or tell them off? Kid decides to press his luck. Well, if the gods are alive, they must be plenty sore. richer for it. Kid ain't found the core, but at least he found Zulf's precious shrine. Pith Orchard. The place is a dead end in more ways than one. Now we can build a shrine of our own, though I got some alternatives in mind. Zulf doesn't touch the thing. Says the god of commotion is no children's toy. The Ura feared the gods. We turned them into toys, put their faces on our walls. That's the Langston River. Used to cut all the way to the wild. Think it was bad then. The Langston River flowed free and wild till the Calamity drank it all up. Maybe all that water just grew wings and flew off. Riverbanks swarming with windbags. They're so bent on finding the core, they hardly notice the kid. Lucky for him, a certain famous ferry barge is still afloat. Weeping Lily. She sends some squirts crying home as she leaves port. Maybe Nelly knows the way to the core. Maybe she can slip right past all the clamor on the coast. Or maybe not. A security skiff pulls up portside. Nelly's just another windbag to those guns. Just then, the windbags notice who she's sailing with. Try to cut her off. They try to slow her down. They try to knock her out. Well, Weepin' Nelly tries harder. Try as she might, though, she hits a snag. Kid's gotta help her get untangled. Favors for favors. At least she picked a good spot for a break, because the core's right there. finds Weeping Nelly raring to go. Turns out she's got a special surprise for when the waters get rough. She's gonna need a little help with all them pickers. Crafty things think they're king of the roost now. The rest of us only wish we could fly in towns like these. Security's gifts keep on coming, starving side. Don't seem to care what they shoot, as long as they hit something. Just gotta make one last stop. With her last breath, Nelly gets the kid to solid ground. Solid ground in picker country. They want that core real bad. Seems the calamity ain't hurt the picker's appetites. Kid nearly fell off the barge back there. Not even once. Now, listen close. You should remember this next part. Why go to Prosper Bluff? To take an enterprising man or a plain old fool to venture out that far. The city was the most beautiful place in the world. We all knew that. But on the other hand, some folks just yearn to see the things they're told they can't. Then that's why you go to Prosper Bluff. Ain't it? There, the kid hears something he ain't heard in a long while. How's it go again? Yeah, that's the one. Yeah. Well, no point explaining what happens next, right? Suffice it to say, kid ain't coming home empty-handed. And besides, it's like the song goes. They'll be here before too long. Darn near celebrated when the kid got back, didn't we? Zolf never thought he'd see a fellow her again. We become fast friends. Calamity has that effect on people. But there was more to be done. There was one last core to find. If only I'd known half the secrets of the Calamity were tucked away in that book, I'd have worked a translator right away. A scientific journal written in Zolf's native tongue. He learned so much from it. Too much. Most of the Ura never got a taste of Ceylandia's fine goods, unless they were born and raised in the city like Zia here. Girl tried to run away from home one time, but the marshals stopped that, didn't they? So many secrets in there, and she can't even read it. Her father's own journal. Kid's surprised when I tell him there's only one core left. I shouldn't have believed it either. Behold, the Pantheon. A Kobe. We track the final core beyond the city to the wilds. Wild unknown. Place can eat a man alive. Place is so raw, even the Calamity couldn't cook it. Not all of it. Know what's better than having to sling a pistol in a fight? Having two. Savage things lurking at every turn. Kiss faster than a slinger with those guns. Pecker's got the core, but they're building a bastion of their own. The welcoming committee scrambles to attention. Didn't expect the kid so soon. They shouldn't have let their guard down. Getting that core was one thing. Getting out's gonna be another. He digs his way out of the clearing, but the wilds won't let him go without a fight. Wallflowers survive the Calamity. It toughened them up. By now, Kid's got more needles in him than a stab weed. Turn your back on a pincushion. Kid's roused up half the wild by now. gets the feeling he's being watched. Not by me, by a lunkhead. And lunkheads ain't fond of two-legged animals. Hit him anywhere but the hindquarters and he only make him mad. Leave it to the kid to make time for stomping swamp weeds. He's anxious to get back. After all, he's got the final core. His journey's over, right? Well, no. It ain't. Not by a long shot. Kid knows something's up when we ain't there to give a warm welcome. See, Zolf and I were just wrapping up a heated discussion. Zolf can barely muster the words. The calamity failed, he says. But I will not. And with that, Zolf leaves us here, alone. Zolf cursed the city, cursed the Bastion, cursed me, said he was going home. When Zolf got through reading that journal, he just snapped, started smashing up the monument till I tried to stop him. Slinger pistols is just the ticket if a hammer's too slow. Finders keepers. Takes a lot of moving pieces to make a dependable sidearm. Ain't never letting go of his old friend with a sturdy grip like that. Zolf banged up the monument pretty bad. But there's a way to put it back together. The shards. We're gonna need all of them to nurse the Bastion back to health. The city brought the shards to the wilds. Now the kid's gonna bring them back. The less said about Drawson Bog, the better. That place will eat your mind. After Zolf's little episode, Kid sets off in search of shards. First stop, Drawson Bog. You'll get lost in that bog, I told the kid, and I won't be able to guide you back. Well, I let him go. What else could I do? What could any of us do? Zolf put us in a real bind. Hurt the Bastion bad. But the shards can make it better. They're like smaller doses of the core's medicine. Shame the only place to fill that prescription is out here in the wilds. This place is intoxicating. Somewhere I never want to go. Survivor? No, ma'am. It's a lonesome ghost of a gas fella. Say to a kid who's seen too much. I'm Zolf of the Ura. Pleased to make your acquaintance. Now the kid sees something stranger still. Did anybody else survive? Sure enough, he finds
peckers, lunkheads, wallflowers, thin cushions, pineapples, swamp weed.
Kid can't fall, no matter how hard he tries. But now the Bastion can send him even farther, into the wild. Kid sets foot inside one of Ceylandia's famous watering holes. Thank you. proper story is supposed to start at the beginning.
It's so simple with this one.
Now here's a kid whose whole world's all right, snoozing there on a rock in the sky. He wakes up. I'm just fooling. He sees what's left of the rippling walls. Years of work undone in an instant. He sees what's left of Piff the Bull. The gods, they're all undone. He sees what's left of his lifelong friend. His friend, he's come undone too. He sees what's left undone. Thought we'd lost him, but he finally comes to. The shard ain't lost either. Not anymore. Now to find a ticket out of this hole. Disgusting things. Ever heard of the lung blossom? It's bigger than the stories say. Scumbag sprung a leak. Say one whiff of lung blossom can make you lose your mind. Kid ain't about to be playing through just yet. Well, the kid prunes it down to size somehow. Mother only knows what happened in the bog. Kid never much cared to speak of it. A shard is like a poor man's core, but beggars can't be choosers. That's it. A few more shards like that, and we'll be back in business. A single shard can breathe new life into this place. The shard's got enough juice to spruce up any of these places.
Ain't saying much, but that's the greatest forge in all the city. It wasn't fixed, it was unbroken. If you're feeling low, count on the buttery flavor of our own Bastion bourbon. The city tried to use the shards to stake out the wild. So much for that plan. Rothus Lagoon. Even the brushers stopped going there. Didn't like being eaten. Ankle gators used to roam the wilds, and they nested at Rothus Lagoon. Many a tale folks use to scare their children straight originated here. All kinds of beasts were going up from down, still lurking about. Brushers learn to fear this place. They used to think that ankle gators were extinct. Well, they ain't. One of them's been living in the tall grass. Turns out Queen Anne got a hold of a shard. Ankle gators love shiny things. Can't fight Queen Anne without the proper tools. Brushers use their pikes to keep their distance around here. Now the kid can do the same. Sharp sticks make Queen Anne nervous, so she backs off a bit. Those pincushions have been living off the ankle gator scraps. Queenie leads the kid into some kind of twisted trap. One bad step in that tall grass and he's Queen Anne's lunch. He holds his ground. Seems the queen's running out of options. The closer you get to an ankle gator's lair, the thicker the tall grass grows. Kid's gotta make a run for it. That old gator's right on his tail. bunch of peggers out of hiding. Gators don't much care for their young. That's why there ain't many around. Can't get hasty in a place like this. Wanna know how to find an ankle gator lair? You use a kid as bait. The shard's sitting in plain view. Now she's coming for him. She's got nowhere else to go. They say if you run across an ankle gator, you better keep running. Starting to get annoyed. Kid's done what needed to be done. Queen Anne's reign is over. We even got a crown jewel. Trouble for a single shard, but you know what? It was worth it. They said Queen Anne was just a folktale. Now there's living proof she ain't. That gator's a crazy gal, but so is the gal who promised to look after her. Arsenal's complete, in case we need protection. The next shard should be farther out there in the wilds. Point Lemaine's grand rail once brought the riches of the wild right to our doorstep.